It was 2007 that we first came across the octopus. We saw an octopus crawling across the seafloor towards a rock outcrop. When we came back a month later, we saw that she was up on the rock and had deposited a bunch of eggs. We realized then that we had a unique opportunity to follow the course of egg development from the beginning, something that had never happened before. Over the course of the next 4.5 years, we went back 18 times. In late 2011, we saw her in September, and we came back a month later and she was gone. In one respect, we were relieved for her that all that effort, all that enduring dedication was over. But at the same time, we were disappointed that we weren't going to be able to see her again, because everyone, the scientists, the ROV pilots, the ship's crews, all began to really pull for her and became fond of her. So it was a bittersweet kind of thing. Octopuses and squids, as a rule, have just one reproductive period, one reproductive event in their lives, and then they die. If this octopus was like all the others that we knew, we were going to be looking at about a quarter of the lifespan. Shallow water octopuses usually live only for a year or two, and they brood their eggs for 1 to 4 months. We suspected that things were going to go a little more slowly in deep water. As we began seeing it prolong more and more, we began to realize that this may be one of the longest living cephalopod species that we know of. And what this is all about is to give the eggs a long time to develop so that when they hatch, they are ready to go and we'll have an excellent chance for survival. Deep water is a harsh environment because it's cold and it's dark and there's a lot of pressure and the food isn't as well distributed as we see it in shallow water. On the other hand, these species are perfectly adapted to their habitat. The deep ocean is the largest habitat on Earth, and yet we're just beginning to understand what's down there. It's really fun.